किने मारी पिचकारी तोरी भीगी अंगिया ओ रंग रसिया हो अरे रंग बरसे।
Happy Holi, guys! The festival of colors, Holi, is just around the corner, and celebrations are incomplete without food. That not only tickles your taste buds, but also cools you down. Some dishes and drinks have been irrefutable Holi playmates for eons. Holi and its love affair with the chaat is known to all. Holi is the ultimate license to indulge in all your chaat temptations. Well, when the temperatures are rising, what better way than to cool the vadas to cool you down? This year, snuggle at home with one such universal food, but with a secret recipe, dahi vada, my mom style. Enjoy! Welcome to Tantalizing Taste Buds, guys. Today, we are going to make dahi vadas. And dahi vadas, that also from a different dal, which my mom makes it. And my mom makes amazing dahi vadas. So, let's understand the secret of her dahi vadas. I have soaked dal overnight. Now this you can see, I have soaked this moong dal. This is with chilka, the green one. And after soaking it for overnight, you can see the green chilkas have already come up, which we can just strain it later on. And then I have taken urad dal also. The proportion of both the dals, 3/4 katori of this dal and 1/4 katori of urad dal. So now let's remove the chilka. I have to put my hand and just try to rub it so the chilkas would come on top, and then take a vessel, take a strainer and try to get the chilkas out like this. You can see it's coming out well. Again, you can see, use the same water and repeat the process, and then the dal would be ready for grinding. So talking about mom's secret recipe, she uses this particular dal, and the proportion also, as I said, this dal is 3/4 and the urad dal is 1/4. So basically this dal makes dahi vadas very soft. As you can see, majority of chilkas are out, so it's not hard and fast to spend more time and to remove all the chilkas. So now here we will just strain this dal. We don't want water. We have taken our dal, moong dal as well as urad dal. I have taken 2 chilies, salt and pinch of hing. And now we will be finely grinding this. We will be using as minimal water as possible. While grinding, you can see the consistency. It's really thick. So I will just add only 1 tablespoon of water. These dals, I have soaked them overnight, so actually they have soaked the water as well, so there's no need to add extra water and it will be difficult for us to make dahi vada. That's why I use minimal of. This is how the consistency of our batter is, and this batter is really fluffy, so this moong dal with skin really helps it to become fluffy. And in case if you think of making this at the last minute, so in case if you want to make it in the evening, you can soak the dals in the morning, but only thing is, do one thing: after washing it, soak it in the boiling water, so the process of dal absorbing the water would be faster, right? Added 1.5 glass of water, 1/2 glass of yogurt, or you can add directly the buttermilk, 1 teaspoon of ajwain, and we'll add some salt, and we will allow this mixture to become a lukewarm and not boil completely. We will do dahi vadas, frying of dahi vadas in a traditional way now. Always before putting dahi vadas for frying, beat the batter well. It has to be fluffy and nice. So now I have already beaten it well, and now we will put it for frying, deep frying. Let the flame be on a medium. We will turn it. Now they have become nice golden brown. Both sides are golden brown.
and now we will remove it out and we will be immediately dipping them in the water, in the buttermilk water. Here. Now we have soaked these in the water. Now you can see how nice and fluffy they have become. You have to take it and press and remove the water between your palms. And this is how it looks. Then insert it in the yogurt. Yogurt can be of your choice, either salty or sugary. Then take this, press it well. Make sure that the iwada doesn't break. Then it goes in our yogurt. And let our dahi vada get soaked into this yogurt, and then we can garnish it and they are ready to serve.
Here comes the Weight Watchers delight, dahi vadas which are non-fried, made in appe pan for my Weight Watchers friends.
Here goes our appe tawa and we will be oiling it. I have this brush, so with the brush I will oil it, grease it well, my appe tawa. And I will allow this appe tawa to heat up. So when we put the dough, we'll have a nice brown effect. So pan is heated up well. Now I will add 1 tablespoon of my batter. So now pan is heated well and immediately we'll get a nice browny effect to our dahi vadas. And after putting all this, we will be covering it and the flame would be low because we need them to cook thoroughly from inside. Now we will see the status after say 5 to 7 minutes. Wow, they are fluffed up really well. I will just again add little oil, coat them with little oil. So when I'll be turning it, we'll have nice oil. Oh, just be careful, this is yet to be done. So now we will see. No, we will still let it cook.
Oh, rang rasiya, rang rasiya. Oh, are rang parse. Do me a favor, let's play holi. Are rang parse. Rangon mein hai pyar ki holi.
Soaked our dahi vada well in yogurt here, curd dahi. So now let's do the plating quickly. We will be taking them in a plate. We will be adding yogurt on top now. Yogurt would be of your choice, sweet or salty. Then on top of this, we will be sprinkling red chili powder. Then I have, I'm using jeera. I have roasted it and made a powder. Then on top of that, we'll be putting our coriander. And then lastly, I'll be sprinkling some chaat masala. So here we go. Our dahi vadas are ready to eat. Doesn't they look yummy? Now with this same mixture, if I put some freshly ground pepper, we can also make nice moong dal bhajiya. So let's try that. And now we can put the small bhajiyas in. Now we'll just turn them around. Can you see how crispy and nice tiny little pepper bhajiyas are ready? Now here you can see our golden brown crispy mug dal bhajiya are ready.
Rasiya, hare rang par se. Do me a favor, let's play holi.